Hi everyone, welcome back to another video. My name is Manuel Espinosa, and today I'm gonna show you the difference between these two pistols. Over here I have the Ruger Max 9, and over here I have the Smith & Wesson M&P 9 Shield. Before I start talking about the pistol, I wanna make sure it's safe. Both of them, you can see there is nothing in the chamber. This one too, is safe, okay? Before I start talking about the difference, I am gonna tell you right now what is the common thing between them, okay? Both of them are 9mm, both of them are micro compact pistol, and also, both of them are having basically the same size. I'm gonna show you right now, okay? I know you can see this pistol and this one, and you can see like this one is biggest, but look at this. When I put together like this, you can see they are pretty much about the same, okay? Now let's talk about the difference. The first difference that I'm gonna talk about is about the capacity. The Max 9 is having a capacity of 10 plus 1. The M&P 9 Shield is having a capacity of 8 plus 1. The next difference is gonna be about the magazine safety. How you can see, both of them are having dome safety over here. Also, they are having a trigger safety, but only this one is having a magazine safety. Okay, so I'm gonna make a little demonstration. I'm gonna use a dummy round. Okay, so the thing with the magazine safety is not gonna let the pistol shoot without the magazine in. And with this one, the pistol is gonna shoot with the magazine in or without the magazine. Okay, I'm gonna show you right now. Now, in this point, okay, the pistol is ready to go. I'm gonna remove the magazine and look at this. The pistol is not working. Also, another cool thing with this pistol is the chamber indicator right here. You can see this red part over here. When you see this part sticks out like this, it's because there is a round in the chamber. Okay, you can see now how the pistol is working. Okay, and look at this. When I remove the round, now you can see how the chamber indicator is flat, okay? With this one, there is no any kind of indicator or something like that. Basically, let's say I am cooking the pistol. I try to shoot, you can see how the pistol is working basically. I can pull the trigger and it's gonna shoot, okay? The next difference is about the iron sight system, okay? This one basically is having a regular iron sight system, and the front sight is tritium fiber optic, okay? This is basically one front sight that is gonna give you one little advantage, because you are gonna be able to see the front sight in the darkness, okay? It's really, really curious, this front sight. I believe it's a good thing, but sadly, you don't have the white point in the rear sight, okay? With the M&P 9 Shield, you have over here the white point. I'm gonna show you right now. You can see the white point, and this is the way how that looks. So, if we make the comparison right now between them, look at this. We'll try to show you. Okay, right now you can see how they look. Okay, this is the big difference. Also, another difference related to the sight system is about this part. You can see over here, this pistol is not optic ready. Okay, basically you cannot attach any optic or anything like that. The Max 9 is coming optic ready. Okay, basically you can attach or install any optic you want. Okay, so I believe something good. Next difference about this is with the sliding. Okay, you can see how it's designed, this thing, and the difference with the Max 9. Okay, basically the M&P is coming with the grip in the sliding right here in the back. So the front, if I try to do a front from the front, it's gonna work as well. I can cook the pistol, I can pull the sliding back, but the thing is, it's not having the same grip that I can find in the back, okay? With the Max 9, I have grip in the rear side and also in the front side. If I try to pull backward the sliding, I can do it really easy. For me, this is something important because not always you are gonna be in the best condition in order to pull backward the sliding. Sometimes we are using gloves. Actually, that happened to me a lot of time. It's really cold, the environment, the temperature, and I had to be wearing gloves. With this pistol, it's gonna be a little hard if I try to pull backward the sliding from this part, because it's pretty much flat, okay? And basically I only can do that from the back, from this part, basically from the rear side. With the Max 9, I can do that from the front and from the back of the sliding. This is something important, okay? However, all depends, because some people never are gonna wear any kind of gloves. If you are not wearing any gloves, it's gonna be always easier to pull backward the sliding. Another thing related to the sliding is about how hard is pull backward this thing. The M&P 9 shield is harder, okay? You need be more, a little more strong pulling back this thing. And the sliding of the Max 9 is soft. Another difference about these two pistols is about the grip, okay? The grip in the M&P 9 shield is biggest, okay? When I am taking the pistol, you can see how my three finger or my three amigos are grabbing really good the grip, okay? But of course, I am extra large size on my hand, okay? I have big hand. In the Max 9, I can grab it as well, but this, the grip is smallest, okay? And also, my pinky is barely taking the grip, okay? This is something important for me because remember, I have extra large hand, or the size of my hand is extra large, but for somebody who is large or medium size, maybe this is not gonna be an issue, okay? I only let you know because, at least for me, it's no big deal, okay? I can shoot any of them, it's okay, but for some people it's important, so I wanna let you know. The last thing about this pistol is about the breakdown system, okay? In the M&P 9 shield, basically most of them are coming like this, are coming with a disassembly lever or breakdown lever, this part over here. Basically, it's really easier to start the disassembly. With the Max 9, it's coming with a crossing pin right here. Basically, this is the breakdown pin. In order to make the disassembly, I had to remove and pull out this pin. Basically, I had to pull out from this side. And the pin is coming out in this direction over here, okay? So basically, this is another difference. I know it's not really important because at the end, always we are gonna be cleaning the handgun, and each brand is different. But some people don't like this system, like a one pin or something like that. They like more something like this. If you ask me in my opinion which one is better, I will tell you that is gonna depend of the use that you wanna apply on each of them. And another thing that I wanna show you, almost I forget this thing, is about this magazine, okay? The reason because I have those magazines here is because I wanna show you something. I almost forget show you this thing, okay? I'm gonna remove the empty magazines, okay? I'm gonna put this over here, okay? The thing that I wanna show you right now is about when you are putting in the magazine in the pistol, okay? For some people, this is a big issue. For me, it's about something not so important, okay? But some people don't like it, so I wanna show you right now. When I had a sliding forward, like I have right now, okay? With this pistol in particular, it's happening this. When I try to put the magazine in, and how you can see this magazine is loaded, full capacity, okay? In this point, it's really hard to put in. Not really, really hard, like a something extremely hard, but you have to apply some force on this, okay? And for some people, this is an issue because they want a pistol without this situation, okay? It's no big deal, but I can tell you it's a little hard, okay? Different thing is happening if I had the sliding backward. Basically, if I had the sliding backward, like this, look at this. I don't have this issue, okay? But the problem is when you have the sliding backward, forward, it's gonna be harder, okay? But if you have the sliding backward like this, look at this. Really easy, okay? Now with the Max 9, it's no big deal. You can see the little space that I had to push the magazine in, and that's it, okay? So in this part, in this situation, the Max 9 is a little better, okay? And also, if I pull backward and I keep my sliding back on this way, when I put the magazine in, it's really soft. It's basically the same thing with this one, okay? The reason because that's happening is because the mechanism of the pistol are making pressure in the magazine when the magazine is going in. So it's not a bad function or something like that. It's that it is. The pistol is coming like this, and you have to take it in consideration because if for you, this is a big deal, it's gonna be better you choose a different model. Maybe you can find this model and you can get it, or any another model, okay? There are another difference, but the difference that I am talking about right now are pretty much the most important, because those different are gonna be basically affecting the way how you are using the pistol. Well, my friend, I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for watching, and I see you the next one. Bye bye.